Right. Lord Jesus. Who are you? Right.
Tell the truth.
Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you?
Tell the truth.
Even the devil would not even understand everybody.
Right.
And didn't care about everybody's person. I don't care either.
That's right.
I'm Bishop so-and-so, and you're going to be Bishop so-and-so in the lake of fire, too.
Amen. Amen.
And I got so many churches all over this, and all you and your church that believe that lie, going to hell, too.
That's right. That's right.
And guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to save myself.
That's right. That's right.
I'm not running with you. Ain't going to believe a lie with you just to fit in.
That's right.
At the end of the day, a lie is still a lie. Right.
Tell the truth.
Amen. And you know what you fall into? You fall into a strong delusion.
Delusion. Right. Amen.
You know what? Let me tell y'all something. It is sad. The Holy Ghost showed me this today about these brothers and these saints. They're delusional.
Yes. Yes.
Delusional. Do you know what delusion is? And I know from first-hand experience, I worked in a psychiatric center.
Break it down.
I know what schizophrenia and delusion is. To have all this type of stuff. To believe something that is not there.
That's right. Amen.
Something that is not true.
Amen.
What happens is there's a lie presented to you.
Mm-hmm.
What is a lie? Something that is not true.
That's right.
But you believe a lie.
That's right.
If it's true.
Amen.
So now that lie has become your truth.
That's right.
And what you just become is delusional.
Amen. That's right.
You become delusional.
Mm-hmm.
And now you have a strong delusion. And the Lord said he was going to send it to the people. He said, I'm going to send a strong delusion to where they would believe a lie. And they believe in it too.
Yes, they are.
And hold to that lie.
That's right.
And no matter how much you tell them it's not true, they believe it anyway.
Anyway.
They're delusional. Let me throw this curveball out there.
Come on now.
Because they watch it anyway.
Come on now. Take your time, preacher.
They're delusional. Right. It's folks that are walking around here, God honest truth, that are telling people that I believe in women preachers. And it's going around.
My Lord.
That I endorse women preachers. It's going around. And it's going around because we fellowship with somebody that allow a church to come to their conference from Canada that believed in women preachers. And because the church in Canada believed in women preachers, anybody that was in this conference where Canada would come believed in women preachers too.
My Lord.
Y'all believe in women preachers with me.
Right.
Devil is a liar.
Because we go to this conference. Because we went to this conference and the church from Canada is there believing in women preachers, but nobody on the board of the conference believed in women preachers. Nobody that attended the conference had women preachers but one church.
Right.
And when the church calms down, they already know what everybody at the conference believe.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
They know everybody at the conference don't believe in women preachers.
Right.
So when they come to the conference, they act orderly. Their women don't get up there and try to preach.
Thank you.
Because they know what the conference people believe.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
They know what they believe.
Come on.
So they simply come for the fellowship.
Amen.
But they don't get up there and preach.
Uh-huh.
So let me tell y'all what happened. I knew the pastor. My grandmother had known this church for years. Knew the pastor, knew the former bishops, knew a whole lot of them for years. But we never attended the conference. So we never, actually we never were getting invites because we didn't get invites and stuff like that because they didn't have our mailing address. So when they finally got our mailing address, they started sending us stuff for the conference. So I had been hearing, and oh, you know they believe in women preachers and blah, 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 blah. Okay? I hear what you say. Sister Danielle, perfect example to help you with what you were talking about earlier today.
Mm-hmm.
I heard before going that these people believe in women preachers.
Mm-hmm.
Had a church from Canada come down, they believe in women preachers, blah, 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 blah. I took what the person told me. I said, okay. And I took what they told me and put it in the back of my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what I did? I received the letter in the mail for the conference.
Mm-hmm.
So I told my wife and I told one of the brothers, because this is wisdom. Before we introduce it to the whole church, we're going to see for ourselves.
Amen.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
That's right.
And before I believe what the person told me, I want to know for myself. What happens is too many times we take people for what they say.
That's right.
And we believe it.
That's right.
And what they said could be a lie.
Amen. Amen.
So you know what the Spirit of the Lord instructs us to do from the Word of God? Speak those things which thou knowest.
That's right. Prove all things.
Testify of the things which thou hast seen.
That's right.
I ain't going to believe your word just because you told me it.
That's right.
Amen.
I got to testify. And I got to speak what I've heard and what I've seen.
Right.
So I don't be found telling a lie. Amen.
That's right.
But these brothers want you to take their word for it. Who are you?
Right.
You're not God. You're fallible. You can lie.
Amen.
So you know what we did?
Amen.
We got dressed up, packed our bag. We're saying we're going to see what's going on here.
That's right.
But even though we're going to see what's going on here, I talked to them. Didn't I do it? I talked to them before we got there. Let me show you wisdom.
That's right.
We're going here. We've already heard what they possibly could believe in. We're going to see what's going on. But most of all, we're going here to fellowship.
That's
and
right.
To magnify God.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
I said, so what we're going to do, we're not walking in with a judgmental spirit.
That's right.
That's right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
To go walking in with our arms crossed and say, I want to see a woman get up.
That's
foolish and arrogant.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
They would have known we came with the wrong agenda.
That's
wrong
right. That's right.
Amen.
I'm coming to praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
But just so happens if I see a woman get up there, then now I know what this person told me is true.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, we won't come back no more.
Right. Amen.
So don't go with the prejudice, though.
That's right.
That they got them and got your face all turned up.
That's right.
And
that's
your nose
right.
all flared up.
Yeah, right. yeah.
Talk to them before we went down. So we went down there. We had a good time.
Right.
Enjoyed ourselves. And we went all 3 days, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And Canada was there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, Canada was there. And I said, all right, let's see how Canada act. We're going to praise the Lord. Let's see how Canada act, though. Praise the Lord, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. All right, we're traveling home on Sunday, talking in the car. Did y'all see any women preaching? I ain't seen no women acting up. Did you see any women out of order? I ain't seen no women out of order. Where they get this from then?
Mm-hmm.
Did a woman preach this weekend? I ain't seen no women preach.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see a woman preacher? I ain't seen a woman preach.
Uh-huh.
Where they get this from then? In testimony service, did you see a woman even try to act like she won't preach?
Nope.
I ain't seen nobody act like they won't preach. Did you see anybody act like they won't preach? I ain't seen.
Nothing.
So I couldn't believe it.
Amen.
And I knew the people in the conference, none of them believed in women preachers.
Mm-hmm.
The issue was not whether they do it at their home churches. It was about the conference.
Amen.
Right. And
Amen.
We saw they didn't have it at the conference either.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
So what did I have to do? I had to dismiss what that brother said.
Amen.
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 Because it wasn't true.
It was a lie.
Mm-hmm.
And let me throw it out here for the record.
Amen.
Since I know they're watching, and we're going to get out of here. I went and told the brother that told the lie. When he tried to tell me the lie again. Trying to tell me the lie again. And I corrected him when he said it.
Thank you, Jesus.
I said, brother, I heard you say numerous of times that these people believe in women preaching. That is not the truth. Mm-hmm. They don't. Mm-hmm. I've been to the church. I've been to the conference. They don't. And you know what the brother did? He went back and kept telling the lie. He went back and kept telling the lie. Was in Wilmington, Delaware. And I'm going to open my mouth wide.
Come on now.
Because I've been holding my mouth for too long.
Come on now.
And they still messing with me, and I ain't messing with them. But since you want to push my hand, here it goes. Brother went to the other brother. Because I told him, when he comes, y'all need to talk about this.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Figure it out. Squash it. Nip it in the bud. God wants to be unified.
That's
God,
right.
Like
brotherly
that.
Love.
Amen.
So the two brothers talked.
Sure.
In the back of the Clarion Inn, when Elder Murray came up to Wilmington, Delaware,
okay.
With Bishop Jory.
Tell the truth, tell the truth.
And while they were standing there talking in the back, the Holy Ghost told me not to move.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
And I stood right there, put my foot on the chair, and I listened to the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
So you all got to have a witness.
That's right.
Especially when you deal with these apostolic folk, you got to have a witness.
That's right.
Some of these apostolic preachers are the biggest liars.
That's right, that's right.
Amen, amen, amen.
That's right.
So I was there, and the two brothers talked. And I heard one of the brothers, the individual who was in question of believing in women preachers and allowing women preachers, he told him to his face, I don't believe in women preachers, never had women preachers. Yes, the church from Canada comes, but y'all don't even know the history of me in Canada. Y'all don't even know how it happened. They wanted me to come there, to their church. I went there, preached, even had to, he dealt with the whole women preacher situation, letting them know what they believe. He said, I told them, respectfully, I will not address your women by their titles.
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe in women preachers.
Right.
He said, because I don't believe in women preachers. Talk to the preacher before he preached at the church. Right. Mm-hmm. It's, I will not address them by their title. So he got there, he said, that's fine. He didn't address them by the title. The brother is telling the other brother this. He said, but no, I've never believed in women preachers. Well, other brothers told me that you believed in blah, 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 Bishop so-and-so, Bishop. He said, but none of them have ever come to me.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, well, maybe you should go to them. Yes.
I want to also add that he had a former women preacher in his church.
That's what I'm about to bring up. Mm-hmm. So he told him, these brothers never came to me. So the other brother told him, well, maybe you need to go to them. He said, no. He said, the Bible said, if you have an altar against your brother, you go to them.
That's right.
Issue with me.
That's right.
You need to come to me.
That's right.
I'm not running after them.
Amen.
I have nothing to prove to them. I have nothing to justify to them. If they have a problem, they should come to me.
That's right. Amen.
He said, I'm not going after them.
Mm-hmm.
He said, many of them have not been in this conference for over years, and they're talking about, but have not yet picked up the phone to talk to them. He said, in fact, I have a former woman pastor. I have a former woman pastor that goes to my church right now.
Mm-hmm.
Since she was one pastor for 40-something years, however many years, 20-something years, 40-something years, whatever the years were. And said, but now she's a mother in my church.
Amen.
Amen.
He said, and she doesn't preach. He said, and I utilize her to teach the other women, you know, for women's sessions, stuff like that. He said, but she doesn't preach. She's a former woman pastor that's now sits under my leadership. He said, I don't believe in women preachers.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So I'm thinking, thank God. It's settled.
Uh-huh.
We can squash it.
Right.
Y'all know later on, and a couple weeks later, I'm on the phone with the other brother. And he tells me. me. that he talked to this brother in Wilmington, Delaware. And the brother admitted to having a woman preacher in his church. A woman pastor. I said, oh, wait, brother. We heard two different conversations.
Wow. Wow.
I said, brother, no, what he said. I corrected the brother again. Right. Mm-hmm. I said, no, brother, what he said was he had a former woman pastor.
Right.
She's no longer a pastor. So he goes on and says, oh, well, maybe I misunderstood what he said. No, you're a liar.
Right, right.
There was no misunderstanding.
That's
you're
right.
a liar.
That's right.
And you want to keep up a lie.
Amen.
Delusional.
You're delusional.
That's right.
Amen.
And I thank God for the way that God does stuff.
Mm.
You know, God is a mighty good God.
Amen. Tell it.
Amen.
He's a mighty good God.
Yes, he is.
He allowed Elder Mary for the fifth Sunday fellowship to have it 1 year in Maryland. Mm-hmm. And we were there.
Yeah.
Mm.
Had it in Westover, Maryland. And y'all know Elder Mary. Elder Mary caught everything.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, we caught everything. And the mother got up.
Uh-huh.
And start testifying.
Uh-huh.
About Amen. How she was a former woman pastor.
Uh-huh. I saw that video.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Smile, you're a camera. It's recording her. And it's recording her in the church of the brother that is accused in believing in women preaching.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Because she is his member.
That's right. That's what he said.
And the fifth Sunday fellowship is taking place in his church.
Right.
And the camera got her.
Yes.
Telling her testimony.
Amen. Amen.
And she told her, a woman preacher, if she preaches, she in sin.
Amen. 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 Amen.
That's right. Yes, she did.
How much clear can it get?
That's right.
You can't wiggle out of this. You cannot leave from watching this video and still say, yeah, that brother's still believing with
uh-huh.
me. Unless you're delusional.
Amen.
You
Amen. Come on, Pastor.
Tell it
like it is.
It's on YouTube.
Yeah.
All y'all can see it.
Yeah.
Go type it in.
Right.
Yep, I saw it.
I put in former woman preacher, and you're going to see Mother Sin standing up there testifying about
uh-huh.
it.
Uh-huh.
Not my grandmother, Mother
right,
Sin.
Right, right.
Testifying about it.
Right.
Amen. Amen.
But yet, people are still keeping up the lie.
Right. Right.
Yep.
And getting other churches involved in it.
Yep.
And then you got other preachers and their members thinking we believe in women preachers. And then when I tell you it's not the truth, they still dumb enough to believe the lie.
Right.
Sowing discord.
Yeah. And sowing discord.
That's yeah.
Sowing discord.
So when I post something on my Facebook status, they want to comment on it.
Uh-huh.
I ain't said nothing to you.
Right.
That's how I check Facebook is public.
That's right.
That's how I check I can put what I want to put on there.
That's right.
But when you step into my territory.
Okay.
I ain't came on your page and said nothing.
Uh-huh.
You stepped into my box.
Amen.
Now you stepped into my box when I post the scripture
right.
that, as if you're trying to condemn me.
Silly.
So I just said, well, praise the Lord. Praise I'm the Lord. I don't know what your intentions was for saying.
Right.
So I try to give people the benefit of the doubt. I've always been this way.
Amen. Amen.
I give people the benefit of the doubt. But when I can discern your motives.
That's right.
And I know something's not right.
Right.
And if God has already spoken something to me, he's going to confirm it.
Yes, he is.
And this happened after I preached the message Sunday.
Wow.
And the Holy Ghost was telling me, they're watching anyway.
Yeah.
Holy Ghost said it, because I didn't know.
Uh-huh.
So really know that somebody was watching, I didn't know, but the Holy Ghost knew.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But even before I preached the message, I went to my wife.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, you should go ahead and just try to reconcile with the brother. She said, because Lonnell, you know, they're not going to do it. You got to do it. I said, I thought about it. I would like to. I said, but you know, the Holy Ghost ain't leading me to do it.
Uh-huh.
Right.
And I said, the reason why, I said, because it's not over with.
Mm-hmm.
I said, until they humble themselves.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Until they humble themselves.
Amen.
There's no point in me talking to anybody.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
No point in me saying nothing.
Right.
So they humble themselves. I said, but they're not over it yet. Mm-hmm. Totally just like that. I said, they're still talking.
Mm-hmm.
I said, they're watching.
Right.
I said, every move we make, they know about it.
Yeah.
Right, right.
Everything that's going on, they know about it. They're watching.
Mm-hmm.
Holy Ghost got upon me. I preach it Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Preach it Sunday.
That's right.
And the Lord was going to allow it to be manifested the next day.
My Lord Jesus.
So now that we have this thing called Periscope. I told you I opened it on my mind.
Yeah, right.
So I already know what the talk is. And I already know that some people have been instructed not to deal with us no more.
Amen.
Because we believe women preachers.
Mm.
We endorse women preachers. I know what the talk is.
My Lord.
So people that used to talk to don't talk to us no more.
My Lord.
Over a lie.
Over a lie.
So you know, my wife, she tried it now. Now that I'm finished giving people the benefit of the doubt.
Right, right.
Now she want me to give them some more benefit of the doubt. I said, I can't do it no more.
Uh-huh.
So y'all tell me this. Riddle me this.
Right.
I'm sorry, y'all open up this can.
Take your time, Pastor.
Riddle me this.
Right.
I get an alert for Periscope.
Right.
And there's this brother going live. Right. I don't have nothing in my heart against nobody. I'm sitting around not doing nothing. Let me watch what you got to talk about. You set the alert, so I watch. I don't mind watching. I don't have nothing against these people.
Mm-hmm.
So I watch. The brother is getting his stuff together. And, you know, hadn't even pulled the Bible out of his bag yet. And it's only two viewers. Me and another sister from his church that he came out of. All right? I don't want to hear the brother. That's what he's talking about. I want to hear the word of God. I don't care who it's coming from.
Uh-huh,
if
uh-huh.
you're talking about, I will watch it. I don't have no problem. I don't have an issue. So, brother gets his Bible out of the bag. He looking at the screen, seeing who, you know, was viewing, because you know it pop up and right. show you who it is. The picture show up.
Right.
And my picture is with me and lady. She's in. All in the camera.
Right.
So ain't no denying who we are.
Uh-huh.
My name is At In His Will 22.
Uh-huh.
So ain't no, I didn't know who you were. So guess what his Bible study topic was for the night? Tonight, I want to talk about people who call themselves apostolic, but now they're incorporating women preachers.
Mm.
Coincidence or not? I said, Britt, come here.
My Lord.
I said, Britt, come here. And I said, I put my Bluetooth speaker in. We got to hear this.
My Lord.
I said, Britt, come in. Do you think I'm just making stuff up now? Have I been giving people the benefit of the doubt for so long and it not can be true? Out of what you want to talk about, when you looked and saw my picture come up, is about people who call themselves apostolic but are incorporating women preachers.
Mm-mm.
I said, all right. Do you see what I'm talking about? Why are y'all messing with me?
Uh-huh.
Why are you messing with me?
That's right.
301-237-9832. Call me. Tell me what
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Maybe I didn't do it slower. 301-237-9832.
Amen.
Call. Why are you messing with me?
Uh-huh.
So he's talking about women preachers. I don't believe in them. So I'm like, heart. What you said is true.
Uh-huh.
I don't believe in them.
Uh-huh.
Let me take that back. I don't permit them.
Amen. Right. Amen.
I don't allow it. None of the churches that we fellowship with allows it.
That's right.
So I agree with the Bible.
Uh-huh.
I agree. So y'all huffing and puffing for no reason.
Amen.
Oh, I lie. I don't believe it. But if a lie comes, I gotta correct it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So as he's going on this teaching, he starts bringing up women prophetess. That the New Testament don't have women prophetess. It's not in the scriptures. Yeah, folks want to run to the Old Testament and show prophetess that, but in the foolish is in the New Testament. So I said, huh? I was like, huh? There's no women prophetess? We're not dealing with women preachers.
Mm-hmm.
If you would have said there's no women preachers, I would have said amen.
Mm-hmm.
You said there were no women prophetess. So I said, what Bible is you read? They're not in the New Testament. You said, huh? There's no women prophetess. Women don't go by that title, prophetess. Where is this at? And I gave him Luke.
Mm-hmm.
About a woman by the name of Anna.
That's right.
Who was a prophetess.
That's right.
So if you're saying there's no woman prophetess, who is Anna?
That's right.
The prophetess.
That's right.
So I was correcting the error that you made.
Right.
And I wasn't doing it with hostility or being mad, but mm-hmm. you made a statement.
Right.
And your statement don't line well with scripture.
Right.
So I'm just sitting trying to help you, brother.
Right. Amen.
So I threw it out there. All right. So I throw it out there. They tell me that it's an Old Testament, Luke is an Old Testament scripture that is being written by someone who is under grace. That was under the law. It's being written by a the Luke is under the law, but they're still under the law, but it's being written by a person who's under grace. All right. The issue that I have is this. Christ came to fulfill the law. Yes, they were still under a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
She's a woman prophetess. She's there and she prophesies the birth of Christ.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
She's there when Christ is born. Amen. All right. I'll oblige you. Go with your doctrine. But what about Acts 21?
Come on now.
With Philip, who had four daughters.
Four daughters. That's right.
And they prophesied.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, they prophesied. Well, it said they prophesied, but show me a scripture where they were walking around prophesying.
My Lord. Come on now.
This is how they deceive people.
Amen.
This is deception.
Oh,
at its finest. Show me a scripture where they were walking around doing it. Whether it was walking around, sitting down, standing up, doing a handstand, I mean,
amen.
They prophesied.
That's right.
Amen.
And the Bible now say they prophesied one time.
Right.
Didn't say they prophesied two times. They said they prophesied.
That's right.
And for him to be able to describe, notice the content of the scripture. He said, we entered into the house of one Philip.
Uh-huh.
They were dealing with Philip.
Mm-hmm.
Who had four daughters who were virgins that prophesied.
That's right.
So for them to bring the four daughters up, them folk knew who those four
daughters
were.
Right. That's right. That's right.
They weren't no fly-by-night females.
No. Nope.
They were women that God used mightily.
That's right.
They were prophetess.
That's right.
And everybody in the area knew who them four were.
That's right.
That's why he brought them up. He had four daughters, virgins, even though they were virgins.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
who prophesied.
Mm.
Yeah, but show me where they walked around doing it. So I asked you, brother, did they do it or did they not do it? I ain't got time for the foolish.
That's right.
I play word games right.
That's right. That's right.
I'm more intelligent.
That's right. That's right. Word games.
We ain't dealing with no fools.
That's right.
Did they do it or not?
Right.
You said no prophets in the New Testament. I showed you four.
Right.
Not one, but four.
That's right.
Amen. And you playing word games with me like I'm dumb. Right. Show me, but I said, brother, let's not try to go with showing me because I will snatch the rug from under you. Don't play with it. Let's not try to go word game saying, show me where it is in the scripture. And if it's not in the scripture written the way that I'm saying it, it's not right.
Right.
Don't play with me like that.
Amen.
Because then I'll expose your folly.
Amen.
And so I asked you, I said, brother, if you want to go that way, y'all got stuff in y'all church y'all doing that ain't Bible.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's right.
Amen. Got to shine a light on it. Where is missionary at in the Bible?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
That's
right.
But you got women down there that call themselves missionaries.
Mm-hmm.
Where's missionary at in the book?
Right.
Where is the title that we give this to women who go to nursing homes and help people and they're called missionaries?
Mm-hmm.
Where is it at in the book?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And then when you're exposing what they got going on to show them themselves, they're looking at you like you got hostility.
Right, right.
I don't have hostility. I'm exposing your folly.
Amen. Right. Amen.
Where, you're being hypocrites. Where's missionary at in the book?
Amen.
This is Jesus' church. It is Jesus' church.
Uh-huh.
Did Jesus put missionaries in there?
No.
So who put them there then, brother? Oh, well, yeah, you're absolutely right. And see, I like the brother because he's honest.
He was honest. Thank you, Lord.
He was honest.
Thank you, Jesus.
I can get along with honest people.
That's right. Amen.
But you had two women who was commenting on it that wanted to be women preachers themselves.
My Lord.
Yeah, you had two women on there cheerleading stuff, throwing out their little commentary.
Mm-mm.
And they were out of order.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
See, you want to talk about women preachers, but here two men of God talking and you running your mouth.
Right, right. That's
you
right.
You commenting while two men of God are talking.
My
what
Lord.
What they should have did was shut up.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
And they should have kept their mouth and somehow the men of God.
That's right.
Snatch the rope from under you again. You got the right one.
That's right.
What they should have done if they were true holy women of God, they should have held their peace.
Amen.
And started praying.
Amen.
And if they felt like I was wrong, they should have started praying and said, Lord, let Pastor so-and-so teach Minister Blair
uh-huh.
so he can see the light.
Right. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
No, your finger's getting happy.
My Lord.
You getting involved in something that you ought not to be getting involved in.
Amen.
Whether it was on a public platform or not, two men of God talking.
That's right. That's right.
He's a pastor and I'm a pastor.
Uh-huh.
Not the men of God talking.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
But you know what I did? I indulged them too. Oh, y'all got missionaries? No, we don't.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
They don't tell me, don't be petty. What kind of terminology is this? Don't be petty.
My Lord.
It's stuff that we do that is not in the Bible, like praise teams. Y'all got a praise team? No, we don't.